single minute. You should accept any high class of Shiksha Guru or Diksha. So he is telling, Raya kahe, Swadharm acharne Vishnu bhakti hai, Varna samma achar bata, Ukshayne param kuman, Vishnu aradhyate panthana, Purushadhar. What is the meaning? You. Very quickly, we have no time.
Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhulika, chapter 8, text 58, translation by Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Vishnu, is worshipped by the proper execution of prescribed duties in the system of Varna and Ashram. There is no other way to satisfy the Supreme Personality of Godhead. One must be situated in the institution of the four Varnas and Ashrams.
Here, Raya Ramananda is telling two things. Goal of the life and the process goal. What is goal? Goal is mukti, liberation, or happiness of this world. Sense gratification of this world. And what is the process? Process, not our exercise, mental or body exercise. Not karma. Karma is always what? Apakram. Karma. What we are doing, jobs and these are karma. Even satkarma. Always dirty. You cannot be cured by these dirty organs. Like an elephant. He takes bath in Ganges. And at once he took so much dust from
by his skull.
And fur. If anyone is dirty and he's taking bath in dirty water, no fruit. So these fruitive kams are always dirty. Or they cannot help. Always some distress will come. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tells. If that karma is to please Krishna, even that Varnasham Dharma, Varnasham Dharma has been established by Krishna himself. So that we will be favorable. And then we can be happy. So if that fleshy karma are offered to Krishna, to please Krishna and Varnasham Dharma we follow, then that goal can be achieved. What goal? Material gratification, sense gratification or swarga, even. Mahaprabhu told, what? Yo baat jaagega. This is extraordinary. We have nothing to do with this. By which only purpose cannot be solved. This is not related to eternal religious. No. What is this? By this, if you are king, like just now we talked about Kailas, or Raman, or Kumbhakaran, or Pralhad Maharaj's father, Hiranyakashipu. So Varnasham Dharma, even though you are following, but not helping so much. So someone tells like that, Swamiji, his Guru Prabhupada came to establish Varnasham Dharma. And we should be in Varnasham. It was his body.
External.
Then, he told some other thing. Then, Raya kahe Krishna karma arpana sarva 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 sarva. Or he was not satisfied, then again he told, what we are doing? Whatever you are doing, fruitive karmas, varnashram dharma, we should try to offer to Krishna. And for this, he presented a Gita slope, evident. Yat karoshi, yadashnashi, yat jahoshi, dadashi, yat, yat tapasyas kalteya, tat purushamara. What meaning?
O son of Kunti, all that you do, all that you eat, all that you offer and give away, as well as all austerities that you may perform, should be done as an offering to me, Krishna told Arjuna.
Then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, oh, it is also external. Oh, go on. And then he told, what he told? Raya kahe, swadharma tyag, eisha prasad. Don't do dharma and don't do adharma. What you should do? Swadharma tyag. What is the meaning?
This is also external, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Rai Ramananda Rai replied, to give up one's occupational duties in the varnashram is the essence of perfection.
Why?
Because then you don't have to suffer. It's a way for relief, so it's again for personal.
If you are offering all your things,
if you
giving swadharma,
if you think it's yours, there's a harm right there because you don't realize that it belongs to Krishna.
When anyone is doing an activity and offering it to Krishna, then they have a misconception. That is false ego. I am the controller, I am the doer, I am the owner, and all of these things I am offering to Krishna.
You are a fruitive karma. Never and never. In a moment you can God. In a moment you can be mad. So you are not doer. Only by the wish of Krishna. And Krishna has given this body. And when he will wish, you can do anything. Otherwise, never. So, you are not doer. If you are doer, then all this is bogus thing. So Mahaprabhu told that. Oh, give up this idea. You should go on. And then he told, oh, for this he gets two shlokas. Bhagyayemam gunana doshan vayadishtan swakam. Dharmam santajya jas sarman ma bhajet sarvadharman parityajya
mamam sarvam bhaja aham tvam sarvapapebhyo moksha icchami.
What is the meaning? Try to hear. Oh, open your eyes and see towards me. Don't be sleep or don't think anything.
Don't go in trance. We are in LA, not in France.
Sarvadharman parityaja, giving up all types of religion and occupational duties. Mam ekam sharanam raja, come to me alone, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and take shelter. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo, I shall free you from all your reactions to your karma, to your sins. Moksha shami, and I will liberate you. Masucha, don't fear.
What is that?
Harm in this?
Huh? Sins?
Sins, pop.
What will he do?
He will burn them away. He will.
What
is the sin? Oh, here, this is the sarva pop. All of these reactions from your sinful activities.
I'll try to understand. Why Krishna is telling that? Oh, I will excuse for your all kinds of sins. So don't fear for the sins you have done. What sins he has done, that is? What was that?
If you give up your religious duties, this may be sinful.
If very, very small children are there, and if you are giving, the way men die, oh, very beautiful, sweet wife, very young age. And if you are given, what she will do? Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu left his Vishnu Priya Devi. And mother and father are old and you have left your house and left your all responsibility and went away in the forest to chant Krishna. What is this? Oh, if you are fearing for this, at once you should give up all kinds of dhan that I have told to you and take my shelter. I am responsible for all these things. Don't be worried. And excuse what offenses or sins or this responsibility you have done, I will excuse for this. But is still Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told what? Oh? You have archer. Why he told you? Radhana. Why he told you have archer? This is very good to take shelter in the Lord's feet of Krishna. Why he told that it is bahya? It is not good.
Because he's talking about
when
he's turning to Krishna.
Give
more
louder. This is one of the highest teachings in Bhagavad Gita, but Srimad Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is rejected as external because he's talking about giving up all external activities and surrendering to Krishna.
Not so much fast, my dear friend.
So this has been rejected as external because Sarva Dharma Pititaja is talking about giving up all one's responsibilities in this world and surrendering to Krishna, but still the platform of service has not been attained. So no service is being rendered, only surrendering, saranagati. We've heard that saranagati itself is not bhakti, but simply the doorway to bhakti. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is asking, oh, if you can speak higher than this, then you should talk higher, speak more.
I could not do
in this slok, Krishna instructs Sarvadharma Pritijaja, give up all your duties in this material world and surrender unto me. The fault that is in this is that simply by giving up one's material activities does not begin one's spiritual activities in devotional service that has not been established. So therefore, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Vairananda to go on and speak more.
Understand? This, oh, giving up and taking shelter of Krishna. Why you are taking shelter of Krishna? Oh, Prabhu, I have done so many things. That is it. Oh, please, that's good. There is no relation with eternal mood, nothing. So here Krishna Mahaprabhu is telling himself that give up this truth. We have no need of doing all this. Oh, only you should chant and remember, be a very high class of devotee. Nothing to do with this. For others, Krishna has established this to do in Gita. And this is the perhaps highest class of Shikshapa called devotee in beginning. But even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected it. Because it has no relation with any
soul.
Our soul, activities of any soul. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told that, gone. Then Raya kahe gyan visha bhakti sadhisha, more superior. He told gyan visha bhakti. And he quoted a slok of Gita. Brahma bhuta prasannatma na sochati na kanchati sama sarveshu bhuteshu madbhaktim labhate. Very good. So, what is the meaning?
Ramananda Roy continues, according to Bhagavad Gita, one who is thus transcendentally situated at once realizes the Supreme Brahman and becomes fully joyful. He never laments nor desires to have anything.
He is equally disposed to every living entity. In that state, he attains pure devotional service unto me.
Pois Brahma Bhuta. Pois Brahma Bhuta.
Here in this verse, Krishna is mentioning Brahma Bhuta Pasanatma. When one is freed from the bodily conception of life, then he realizes, I am the soul, I am eternal, I am not part of this material world. Yet in this verse, no reference has been made to service to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Srimad Bhagavatam gives the conclusion, Naiskamyam Apichuta Bhava Chobitam Nagyanam Niranjanam Kutapuna Shashvadabhatam Ishure Nachaptam Kama Yadapya Karanam. Even if knowledge is pure and transcendental, yet it is devoid of a conception of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and service to Him, then it is not very attractive or perfect. So here, as someone who is liberated from the bodily concept of life, they may have the chance to attain bhakti, but here it's not described what that bhakti is or how it can be attained through association with pure devotees.
That is why Mahaprabhu rejected this highest class of sloka of Srimad Gita. Oh, your Gurudev also. They told that you should follow Gita. This is the base of bhakti platform. We must, in first stage, we should follow. But after this, if you are, you have become, oh, you have taste in Hari Katha, and you have taste to hear the sweet pastimes of Krishna, then you can reject, oh, this philosophy of Gita. Gita is essence of all Upanishad. But Srimad Bhagavata is the essence of all the Ved, Puran, Shastra, everything. Nigama Kalpataru Galita Rishamalayam Muhuraho Mushrasikao. Even one sloka of Srimad Bhagavati, if you have heard, even one sloka. And you have taste in hearing and to know, curiosity to know the meaning. What is the meaning? Deep meaning. Oh, you have passed the examination of Gita. Now you should begin and try to enter in the realm of bhakti. Pure rasa bhakti. So Mahaprabhu told, rejected also. And then he told that you should go on. Then what he told? Raya kahe gyan sunya bhakti sadhya sar. Oh, he told that, oh, where there is no gyan, no karma, no covering of gyan and karma. Anya pilasita sunyam gyan karma adhi anadvrtam. So this is sadhya sar. And this is the goal of our life. Jnane prayasa madupasya namanteva jivanti sanukharitam bhavadiya bartam thane sita sudigatam tanuvam manovir je prayaso ajita jito apitrai hatrai lokam. What is the meaning?
Roy Ramananda continued. Lord Brahma said, my dear Lord, those devotees who have thrown away the impersonal conception of the Absolute and have therefore abandoned discussing empiric philosophical truths should hear from self-realized devotees about your holy name, form, pastimes and qualities. They should completely follow the principles of devotional service and remain free from illicit sex, gambling, intoxication and animal slaughter. Surrendering themselves fully with body, words and mind, they can live in any ashram or social status. Indeed, you are conquered by such persons, although you are always unconquerable.
Here, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, person, you are boy, oh, this can be also, but can be also.
Maybe.
And he was not satisfied with his heart and he was not happy. But anyhow, where there is no gyan, karma to cover Krishna bhakti. Gyan and karma will have to follow till your life is, your bound. But they should be favorable to bhakti. They should be children to bhakti. Not that covering bhakti. So we should know what karma and what kind of gyan is favorable for bhakti. And those karmas and gyan, those who are not favorable, we should keep out all this. Then you can know this thing. So wherever you are, either in house family life or in renounce order, like a brahmachari or vanaprasthi or grihastha or brahmachari, normal, you should be there. Vatu thane sthita tanu vang manobhi prayasuvat. Oh, always hear the sweet glorification of Krishna, pastimes of Krishna, very powerful. They will remove all your unwanted things very soon. So you should hear the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, oh Radha and Krishna conjugal. And if you want to test it all very soon, then you should try to hear the glorifications and the process of and life of bhakta, like Raghunath Das Goswami, like Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, and all our acharyas. You can hear the pastimes of Prahlad Maharaj in beginning, also Lal Charitra, Chitraketu Maharaj Upakhyan, and all. And Jagai Madhai hearing, and others, especially Rupa and Raghunath. Very quickly you can attend this thing, very quickly. So he is telling, oh, Jnane prayasam dupasyanamante eva jivante sumakharitam bhavati yavartam sthane sthitatamva. Oh, you should be where you are and always here. Glorify what? When you go to this council of hearing like this, you should do pranam to all the devotees who are here. Especially to that person who is giving, oh Hari Katharsvi. And to the place where it is going on. And those who are organizing for Dukhana. By what? By tan, by body, and by mind. Shastan pranam. Like Hanuman, he used to do. Like Prahlad, like all. Also like Rupa Goswami, he used to do. Or he used to do pranam to all. So you should also. No friction will be there. Always honoring all. And hear very patiently. Hear to, not to only hear. How to? How you should hear? To follow, totally. If you are not going so deep, then again serve any high class of devotee. Otherwise you will understand what he wants to tell, you cannot. You can do opposite. You cannot go. So Mahaprabhu told, oh, very good. It is something. But go, Brahma.
Hari Bo!
I will myself invite you all to be in class at 5. We are tomorrow also. And we should try to keep this. Oh. Radharaman Sambhad in a very brief way. And this is the essence of a whole Chaitanya.
Hare Krishna, some devotee has requested for initiation. So whoever want initiation, they will register their name with Sripad Aranya Maharaj or Sripad Vajanath Prabhu or Samarani Didi. So initiation will be in Gurudev's Bhajan Kuti tomorrow 9 a.m. And day after tomorrow Gurudev will leave for Houston, so only tomorrow is time. So many devotees has requested for initiation. So I am requesting you all, whoever want initiation, please register your name with Sripad Arunna Maharaj or Sripad Bhajanath Prabhu or Samrani Didi. These will take place tomorrow at 9 a.m. House of Sarbhuj Prabhu. You can contact the Sarbhuj Prabhu or Sarbhuj Prabhu. Found and lost property in Bajal. Lost and found. As you Gurudev will not give class in morning time because the initiation is there. We will come here about
yes, the words can come from the Masonic Lodge tomorrow morning at 9 o'clock. At 9 a.m. tomorrow, everyone can come to the Masonic Lodge, which is right next to the ISKCON Temple, Los Angeles, on Venice Boulevard. And we also will be serving lunch there tonight. Prasadam will be at the Boathouse, which is 2 miles north of here on Lincoln, then left on Mindanao into the Marina del Rey Harbor. We're going to request Arunya Maharaj to give class tomorrow. If he agrees, then he will give class. Otherwise, there are other devotees who can also give.
For who the address is not clear. Not clear.
Also, Shamarani may also give class tomorrow.
Also, tomorrow night is the deadline for Russian visa applications. They're going out Monday to Washington, D.C. It takes 2 weeks to get them, just in time for us to leave for Europe. So if you haven't gotten your application yet, come and see me, because you have tomorrow to get your photos and applications and money to me if you want to do it with a group. I'll be here tonight, and all day tomorrow I'll be at apartment number 5, or there will be applications available. Mr. Chintaprabhu's apartment across from the temple. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Mother Yashoda, I want you to meet my wife. This is Sita Priya. Mother Yashoda, known her for many, over 15, 20 years in San Diego. No, Sita Priya. Sita. Sita Priya. And our daughter, Sri Radhika. Okay. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Did you get the diamonds too?
You got yes, me on the jam.
Yes, I do. You do? Oh, great. Can you tell me a little bit about that? How we got it and everything like that? If you don't mind?
Books?
Yes.
Well, I just know that Prabhupada had maybe 7 or 8 friends of mine.